Hey, I'm Jonathan, and this is Rad-head. Today I'm building this spinning contraption, which by itself doesn't look too impressive, but combined with this special curve, it performs a seemingly impossible motion. When I first saw this, I was so amazed I just had to build my own version, with a few extra features. Let's start building. For the base, I'm cutting a bunch of pieces of birch plywood to size. I want the top of the base to be thicker, so I'm gluing two pieces together, clamping them and cleaning the glue squeeze out with a wet rag. The bottom part of the holder will have a compartment to hold additional curves that the rod can fit through. The compartment is made by gluing thin strips of plywood on three of the sides. After the glue had some time to set and before permanently attaching the two parts of the base, I had to drill a bunch of holes in the top part. I started with a 7/8 of an inch hole partway through to hold a couple of bearings. I finished this hole with a 5/8 of an inch bit, drilling all the way through. On the other side, I drilled partway through with a 9mm drill bit. This hole will hold the different curves. It's time to glue the two parts of the base together. Once dried, I cleaned the base over the table saw, removing just enough material to reveal freshly cut wood on all four sides. Sanding a little to remove any burn marks. Now I can start working on the rod assembly. I've cut the necessary sections out of this 8mm stainless steel shaft using a cutoff wheel. I cleaned each cut edge with a file using the simple jig I made over the table saw. The shortest section needs to have some pretty intricate features machined. On the lathe, I started by center drilling, then drilling with a 3.5mm drill bit, using plenty of cutting oil. I then tapped the hole to accept an M4 bolt. A small flat was filed using the same jig from before. To prepare this piece for soldering, the edge should have a rounded recess, which I made with a round file. Can you see how much I love filing? It's important that the recess is exactly aligned with the flat on the other side. I placed the two rod sections so that the recess fits perfectly around the other piece, centering it as best as I can. For holding the pieces in place while soldering, I just used some heavy metal blocks. Using an oxypropane torch, I heated the joint until it was glowing red, then just touched it with some flux-coated silver rod. It's amazing how little silver you need in order to make a really strong bond. After it cooled, I cleaned the joint over at the belt sander. In order to make the metal part that hold the different curves, I need to cut miters on this tiny angle iron, which by the way is a part of an old drawer slide I had laying around. I started by roughly cutting to 45 degrees with the angle grinder and finishing off with a file. I placed both pieces on a square metal block and silver soldered them together. I started making the curve that the rod will fit through. I've cut a piece of tinted acrylic to size at the table saw. I spray glued on the curve template, then started cutting it on the scroll saw, taking it real slow. Using a sanding drum on the Dremel, I cleaned up the curve, smoothing any kinks the saw might have left. This process results in a surprisingly smooth curve, which many people mistakenly thought was laser cut. I marked and drilled holes for super small magnets to fit in. They are only 2mm in diameter. I added a tiny amount of acrylic solvent into each hole and then pushed the magnets in to get a nice tight fit, pressing them flush using a plastic tool. The final step before we can put it all together is making a tight fit between the 9mm hole in the base and the curve holder. In order to do so, I came up with this solution. I filled the hole with epoxy and inserted the curve holder, not before I dipped it in some plain vegetable oil. It will act as a release agent. I snapped the curve onto the holder to act as a spacer to know how deep the holder needs to get inside the hole. I clamped it straight using a straight edge and let it cure for 10 minutes. Meanwhile, I added two skateboard bearings with a couple of 3D printed spacers in between. After the epoxy had cured, I came and simply pulled out the holder, leaving a hole in the exact shape to accept the curve holder. I gave the base a couple of coats of varnish, and now it's time to assemble everything together. On the main shaft, I slid a small piece of tube with a tight friction fit. On the other side, I inserted a custom 3D printed connector that will connect the shaft to the T-shape we made earlier. A small compression spring is inserted in the hole and the two parts are connected together with an M4 bolt. This custom connector allows the T-shaped rod to be rotated in discrete increments of 30 degrees. Inserting the shaft, curve holder and curve, we can finally enjoy this oddly satisfying motion. I made additional curves to fit all other possible orientations of the rod. They all snap to place easily with magnets. When done playing, the curves fit snugly in the compartment. If you're curious to find out what exactly is this curve, then stay tuned for my next video, in which I'll try to explain what exactly is going on here. On my website you can find plans, templates and models for the 3D printed parts for those of you who wish to build one. If you enjoy my videos and want to help me produce more of them, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Until next time, bye!